Hi everyone. So in this video, we will talk about input type radio. I mean, how to render the radio component, radio field using FormIP form tag. Okay. So in the previous video, we talked about select. Okay. So it's not going to be much different, like because input type radio is coming with the input property like input type name, input type text, email, password, file. Similarly, there is an input type radio. Okay, so we are not going to use this component select for that, because that we can compensate with this only. Here what we need to do, if we just try to see one property here, name, email, what other property we can add as a radio button. Okay, so prefix I can say Mr. Mistress or options. Let's say we wanted to add a domain, your website domain, okay? Either it is a .com, .net or something, okay? So in that case, what we, so domain is the property. So here in the field tag, we will just use the same property. Here we will just use field type radio. Similarly like input type email, right? So we will write field. So here in terms of type, it will be radio and name. Name will be domain, like your website domain, .net, .com, .in, anything else. So value will be .com. Okay, this is more of my field tag. But radio buttons are like, those are like, need to have a same common name property. So I can create n number of radio buttons. They will be combined in one group. So here is a .net, okay. .in can be another one. So input type radio, name should, property should be common if you want to bind them in a group, because radio button always comes with a two or three options. You can choose one of them, right? If there are more options, you move to select, you move to drop down, right? So here I have a 2-3 options only, and you can write error message, component same for domain, it will show. And if you wanted to print the values, which value you have selected, right? So I can just write one span tag. That you can, what value you are getting is values dot domain. It will give you the value which you have selected. Okay, plain and simple, I think. So these are the input type, text, password, all we are using field tag. So similarly, we are not using any additional component as a radio, same as select. We are not using that. We are just using simple field tag with type radio. Name property should be common. This condition also holds true for the HTML forms, right? Only the value property is getting changed. So whatever you are selecting, that will be populated. I think same condition will apply to the checkbox. Let's see that checkbox in the next video, and we'll create a baseline for the dynamic forms from JSON.